that that true word, that word of truth in, that incorruptible, undefiled seed that's Christ, that word of truth from the beginning, if you're going to bring that in and realign the structures of your anatomy, because, you know, you're here to prepare yourself a body. You know, this is a body you've got. You can change it, rearrange it once you've got conscious control over it, but you're going to have to access the annals of time and send the living light of Christ back down through the generations, and, you know, you're going to help those parts of you to find themselves as well. And that's what I like about Jesus. You know, he said in the Bible, it said he went back down, you know, to those in the time of Noah, and he went to hell to preach the gospel to those of the time of Noah. It's like you're going to go back and you're going to preach the gospel to your ancestors. And that's one of the things that Jesus taught me. And one of the main things that I did, like going back into the late 90s, I grew a very, very long beard, right down to my navel kind of thing, a very long beard. And I used to go out at night, you know, I'd be laying in bed, and I'd go out of my body, and I would go back, and I'd see myself standing on a hill teaching, you know, hundreds and thousands of people. And so what I was actually doing was I was going back to generational lineages of mine, and I was actually bringing them a new truth, you know, because I reckon, you know, we've all been corruptors, we've been corrupted, and we've perpetuated the corruption through generations, through, you know, just speaking the words of dead men to our children. I went back into many, many space-time, you know, experiences of mine, and there I was correcting my error, and I was teaching a different message. And that's something I did for years and years and years, you know. There I was. I went back with this big, long beard. It's like I had to grow that beard. It's one of those things that I heard God saying, you know, grow a beard. And a lot of other people said to me, Grant, grow a beard. You said, there's something about you. You've got to go and grow one. And, you know, after many witnesses, I decided to grow it. And then I found out that I was traveling, you know, in my night state into other dimensional times and, you know, incarnational ages of time, you know, epochs of time. And I was preaching. So what I was actually doing in those times is I was changing the consciousness in the past of many generations. And so now, say for example, I went back 3,000 years ago and I was preaching and teaching a different method and you know, a different witness, you know, a different teaching. Not the corruption anymore, but, you know, a true teaching that I'm starting to understand now. If I was teaching the people back then, they would then also be changing. They would be learning a different thing. They would be teaching their children a different thing. And they'd be creating different probability lines of expression in the now moment. Now, the world's pretty corrupt, but I've been going back and doing that kind of teaching for a long time, and I believe now that in my understanding that the world can change very, very quickly when everyone starts to teach their ancestors the reality of the truth that's found now in Christ in us. So as the word of truth would speak through us, we can actually go back in space-time and change the probability lines. And when everybody starts to do that, this world will very, very quickly change, because all of a sudden there'll be a shift in the probabilities of the projection of the hologram. Everyone would have been taught something else at a prior date. You know, the past will be different. You know, I've often said, you know, we project a future, and it's from the past that we do project a future. So the illusion is projected from a mind of separation. The world of illusion that we see here, or the vain imaginations, the vain images that we see here, is a projection of a past record in our mind. Now, the living memory matrix doesn't project. It emanates and radiates the light of the glory of the countenance of the presence of the living one through the open gateways of the structure of your temple, and there would be a radiant glory come out of you. But the projection of the hologram and the projection of the body of deception, which is only a projection of unassimilated records in time, you know, you had those charges against you and you couldn't assimilate back down into your living memory matrix, so you've projected the delusion, you've projected the illusion out into a future. So the past rejected words, you know, Adam and Eve parable, they were rejected. They couldn't get back into the garden. They were rejected, so they projected a mind of their own. So everyone in the world's been projecting a world version or a world view of their own from a deluded mind. and it's a projection into a future. And so we walk into the future, like today, right now, right here, is yesterday's tomorrow. So if, when you say, oh, tomorrow, and then tomorrow comes, it's today. And then when you're in today, it was yesterday. So yesterday projected today, which was yesterday's future. And so when you're projecting constantly from the past into the future, the delusion of the error of thought that's being filed down in your biological computer, and everyone's doing it, you know, there's going to have to come a time when everyone decides to undo that, you know, rewrite your book of life. And it's in your night state, it's in your dream state, it's in your asking, I want to do that. It's in the knowing of the technology, it's in the knowing of how the consciousness works, it's in the knowing that you can be guided to choose again and renew your mind. It's in the knowing that you'll do it, you know. And so, you know, if there was a way to do it, obviously it's been found, you know. Yeah, that's right. As we preach, we're teaching those before us exactly their groundbreaker. And that's the wonderful thing about it, you know, like there's a verse in the Bible that says, and this is the gospel that was preached to Abraham in advance. And what does that mean? If the gospel was preached to Abraham in advance, you know. So, and that's the everlasting gospel. So, you know, there is something in us that can learn how to undo the error of thought and to cast down, you know, those strongholds, pull down those strongholds and, you know, those vain imaginations that are in our mind that are projecting this delusion. And the more of us who understand the technology and how to do it, the quicker it's going to happen. So, there must be an alternative. If people aren't aware of the technology that's here now coming into the planet in this current stellar activation cycle, if they're not aware of it and they're trying to work out their salvation through reading the Bible or through understanding the text or, you know, through some method of, you know, New Age, you know, angels and New Age masters and guides and ETs and UFOs and lords and all the other stuff that they're trying to call on, and they're trying to get some other entity, you know, to help them. They can't, because they don't know the reality of the true structure of consciousness, how it works, how the creation mechanics came about, how you store information, you know, in your particle universe, antiparticle universe, how you access the archives to create your hologram. And, you know, they don't even realize half of the principles in creation, you know, that are working to create even their own body or experience. So, you know, they're trying to use the thoughts of this world to just get the best picture in this world. You know, they want, you know, to be in control of their world. It's a decaying world. They can't really be in control of it. But they want to manipulate everyone else or get the most amount of money or, you know, get a different kind of lifestyle through, you know, controls and things. But they all end up dying, you know. And that's one of the things I was trying to get through to some of the people I talked to. That, you know... one of the biggest problems in, you know, spiritual teachings is that people say, oh, look, you know, life and death is that's the way it's supposed to be. You know, it's just natural. You know, you get old, you get sick, you die, then you reincarnate again, and then you have another go, and you're just slowly, you know, moving onward, and you're just gaining experience along the way. But people don't realize that there is no death. You know, it's been abolished, it doesn't exist, it's an unreality, but it is our experience here because of the corruption. And the moment that we realize that it is corrupt, and we look into what has corrupted it, and how the intruder race lines, the alien invaders, have come in through mind manipulations and controls and technology, hybridization and genetic programming, you know, through abduction techniques and causing us to be... under their control remotely from, you know, a parallel universe. Once you understand the history of the world and how we have been influenced and how, you know, it's not really our fault in some ways, because, you know, we grow into this world as children and we're just being taught by this world that's corrupt. But when you realize that and you realize that the opportunity is here to overcome death in the body by the true alignment and the true flows and the through you know, the rivers that run through you and bring the washing of the water of the word of regeneration. You know, what comes into you from the inner kingdom reality and rewrites your book of life. And that you can overcome death in the body. You know, Jesus demonstrated it. You can overcome death in the body through the knowledge of the truth and the perpetual motion flows that come through the divine order and the right timing of the true alignment. You see, like, if people knew there was an alternative and that you don't have to die, people say, oh, but I don't fear death. Well, good on you, you know, if you don't. It's an unreality, but you're going to find yourself back here in another bodysuit. You're going to come back here in another chemically coded coat of corruption, trying to work out your salvation or at least eke out a living in this world. You're trying to, you know, come into a world of oppression and you'll feel very miserable and you'll be in a sufferance, you know, you'll be oppressed because, you know, you're either living in opulence or you're living in mediocrity or you're living in sort of poverty or, you know, something in between, some of those shades in between. But you're never really happy because you know inherently within you that you want to overcome it. You want to be in control of your life. You don't want to be under the weather of the oppressor. You don't want to be held down here in containment. You know there's something more to it than what you're experiencing. So unless people understand that there is a reality field of life that actually escalates up through quantum leaps into higher dimensional structure of consciousness, and the natural organic process of resurrection would be to accrete to yourself in the time cycles provided you, the laying down of your DNA strands of experience, of living memory, that you can now migrate your consciousness to higher dimensional structures and experience your realities. Now, if people knew that, I'm sure they'd choose it, right? If people knew that, they would choose it, if they could see a clear picture of that. You know, but I speak to people, you know, it's quite amazing. And I can understand why. It's like you say something to somebody, and it just does not compute. Well, how can it? If they've been taught, you know, through eons of teaching and, you know, all of the ancestral teachings that have filed down as DNA constructs of sounds, sound tones or voices of dead men resonating in them, and it's instinctual, habitual kind of responses that they have encoded into their bodies, you know, how can they listen to something else? It has to be, it has to come through divine connections, and it can also come through, you know, in the Course of Miracles it says, when I'm healed, I'm not healed alone. So when one person wakes up, it starts to, genetically, we're coded together, it starts to waken up others because the genetic codes are talking through the fabric of the matrices of the flesh. You know, when Jesus woke up, and it says, when Jesus was resurrected, what did it say? A whole legion of saints came out of their graves and came into the city of Jerusalem. So it means that when Jesus woke up, he cracked the codes. It said the rocks were split, which means the hard crust or the hard shell of the encasement is like a seed. The seed needs to really get the water and crack open before the kernel of the seed can come and take root into the soil, you know, and come to a new life. The rocks were split, and the saints and light appeared in the holy city. So it means some others woke up when Jesus woke up. And so when you wake up, rushing down the annals of time and into the matrix of the genetic coding of the fabric of humanity, you know, you're going to wake up too. Because like when Jesus went to heaven, okay, so Jesus rose up, and we're all seated back in heaven, by the way, as a part of him. Because, you know, we're all members one of another. And when he received us all under himself, every member in creation became his divine reformulation. He ascended, and part of his makeup is each one of us, you know. And so he's up there. Well, you might say he's returned to heaven, but that's the waking up that's in us. Like, we're rooted in heaven, and we've got a connection in there. Who in heaven have I but thee, you know, it says in the Bible. And we've got to realize that, you know, it's the internetworking of the communication cords of the fabric of the DNA. Even though they're corrupted, we're connected together in discord. And when we do wake up, it's going to shine light through the cords of community where we're living. And others are going to get a glimmer or a taste or a hint, a flash, you know, of a glimpse, a fragrance of the fact that they have got this inner reality within them, you know. And so there's going to be an awakening anyway. But you can intentionally do the techniques to actually stimulate the resurrection process, where you're downloading codes intentionally through the technology website,